Muhammad, he made sex legalized without marriage. He called it muta, and this is in the Quran, chapter 24, verse number 4. Look what Muhammad said. Allah apostle said, if a man and a woman agree, and between two brackets it says temporary marriage. The fact, it does not say that. It's a lie. This is why it's between two brackets, actually. To have ishra, ishra is not marriage, to have sexual relationship. So we take off the marriage. Sex. This is just sex. Pure sex. No marriage. Don't lie. That's why it says the three, you know, if any man and agree for what? To have sex should last for 3 nights. And if they like to continue, they can do so. And if they want to separate, they can do so. And the Muslim, they call that muta'a, marriage. Muta'a in Arabic mean joy. Specifically here, sexual joy. The muta'a is halal. It's so beautiful. You go in the elevator and you are a woman with you in the elevator. She is a believer in Allah. Beautiful believer, decent, very decent, wearing hijab, burqa, I mean, 5 kilograms of makeup, 70 kilograms of perfume. And you say to her, sister, can we have muta? She will say to you, oh, sorry, I don't do this stuff. How much you offer? You say, oh, you don't do it, but you're asking me how much. Yes, you know, let us see, let us discuss. I don't know really how you look like. You are wearing hijab, so I don't know what is your price. Are you beautiful? She will say to you, very much beautiful. Oh, your voice look like a man. What happened now? Very much beautiful. Okay, I will give you $25. $25? Are you crazy? Zakir Naik, he paid me $35 last night. What's wrong with you? Let us go to Zakir Naik and ask him about this situation. Remember, Zakir Naik will not answer the phone unless it rings 3 times. This is Islamic. Everything 3 times. Assalamu alaikum. Christian Prince, I told you 1 billion times, don't call me. I am not the only Muslim in the world. Leave me alone. Brother, but just we have a question. Just one question about the Prophet said, if a man and a woman, they agree to have sex together, they can do that for 3 days, 3 nights, and if they like to extend, they can extend. Can you explain to us? What is the problem? As an example, you are going to the mall and you see someone, see the beautiful, and see the decent woman, and see it wearing hijab. Nobody can see her skin. Very decent woman. How you can see her skin? She will not allow you. So you say to her, I would do muta. Muta simply is a way of doing sexuality without being caught by the law. Oh, so you are saying we can have sex and we will not be punished? Absolutely. So you say to her, I will do muta with you. And if she agree, and she agree about the amount of the money she will give and you will receive, simply you have a contract. But be careful. First of all, you have to say exactly how much the money you will pay her. Secondly, you have to make it clear how long you are going to do bang, bang, bing, bong together. And if you agree, it is the principle. And please stop calling me. Call Zakir Naik, my brother. Thank you. This is Islam. This is, if we go to try to understand the muta, we will find this. Muta is a type of marriage used some way, same way as permanent marriage, nikah. This is the Muslim opinion, by the way. Not me, which is a lie. In order to make man and women physically halal, you see, physically halal, it's about physically to each other. A muta is temporary marriage that end at fixed period, which mean if a man, he say to a woman, I want to have bang bang bing bong with you for 3 hours. When the 3 hours is over, there's no need for a divorce. There's no divorce in muta marriage. It's not a marriage because it's a sex contract. They call it marriage. Read with me carefully. Muta is a type of nikah until an agreed time. And it can be for a day, 2 days, for a month, or a year or 3 years, etc. Still, it's muta. You can hire women for 3 years just for sex. And this is the reference, Sunan Ibn Majah. Imam an-Nawawi, in his commentary of Sahih Muslim, relied the definition of muta advanced by Imam of Ahl Sunnah al-Qadi, etc., Qadi Ayyad. The scholars, ulama means scholars, agree that muta is a nikah in which the husband and the wife do not inherit from each other, and separation would took place on completion on the specific time without talaq. Talaq means divorce. Do you see what muta now? So if you agree with the women, we will have sex for 3 hours, and the 3 hours is over, there's no divorce. Number two, what if the man, he hire a woman to have sex with her to do muta, and he die, the woman she would not inherit, because it simply is a, she is a, this is prostitution. Or what Muhammad, he did, he just legalized prostitution. You can hire a woman for sex, you know what I mean? This is Islam. How you can do muta? The reality of the muta, that a marriage performed with the women, words added in, like, you know, you have to say, I marry you muta to for sex for, you know, 10 days. If you say that and she agrees, she said I agree, and then you said to her, I want to pay you $10. If she agree, that's it, that is the muta. So for example, a man shall say, shall remain as my wife for a month, and I shall have nikah muta with you for a year. The parties themselves act as witness. It occur in the presence of wali or witnesses, or without them, which means he can do it with any woman alone. If you, even if there's nobody, you go to a woman, you say, I want to bang bang with you, how much you charge me for 2 hours, she agree, you agree, this is halal. Very open-minded religion, brother. Do you see it? Contracting the muta, just like the nikah, both require a specific word to make the contract halal. It's magical word, there's magical. Both type of marriage have dower. What dower? It's a money you pay for sex. What dower? You know, the difference between the muta and the nikah, that there is no specific time scale, a time or a scale necessarily. What type of women you can contract muta with? Same, you can any woman, just you agree. Okay,